Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I'm making 10 cards using the October Card Kit by Simon Says Stamp, and there is a giveaway on my blog on this card kit, so make sure to visit. Now before we start with the 10 cards, let's take a quick look on what's included in the kit. So first of all, you get your lollipop, just like always. You also get 3 cards by Gina K Designs. These are printed cards that you can use with foil, and you also get foil here, and you can run them through your laminator and they are going to turn into gorgeous looking cards. Now in the package you will get lots of foils. As you can see, there are 12 in total, and there are actually 6 different designs, so you get 2 of each design. Now there is another fun thing in the kit, which is alcohol lifting, and they also give you 3 different colors of alcohol ink. So there are so many different techniques that you can do using this alcohol lifting, and I'm going to make actually 4 cards today using these products. And in the kit you will also find Yubo cardstock, which is perfect to play with your alcohol lifting as well as your alcohol inks. So you can cut them in half and you can create 6 panels out of all those Yubo papers. Now you also get this gorgeous stamp set with this beautiful flower arrangement. You also get lots of sentiments as well as individual designs that you can stamp. And this is called Sketched Flowers. It's a beautiful stamp set, and I think that you can grab it separately if you don't want to get the kit. And you also get 3 different colors of cardstock. Now this time with my cardstock I just cut it in 4 pieces that are all 4.25 by 5.5, so I ended up having tons of panels that I can use on my cards later on, and I can always use my card blanks that I have in my stash for my card bases. So first I'm going to play with my alcohol lifting and my alcohol inks. I'm going to cut out my Yubo paper into panels that are all 4.25 by 5.5, so I can create a few backgrounds, and then I'm going to turn them into cards. For the first technique I will be using my blending solution. If you don't have blending solution in your stash, just use alcohol, rubbing alcohol. So I'm going to apply my ink directly on my Yubo paper, and this is a great technique for beginners, especially since you don't have to worry that your colors are going to turn matte. I'm just working with one color here. The blending solution is helping the color to move easier, and you can also add even more color like I am going to do here, and then blow it with your straw. Another great technique and super easy to do. So I'm going to let this dry and I will get back to it later on and turn it into a card. Now for the next technique I'm using some felt on my blending tool. I have these old rectangle felts that I'm just cutting out with my scissors, and I'm going to add some a couple of colors on my felt. I am using only 2 colors here, the blue and the yellow, which I know they blend nicely, and I did add some blending solution as well. One way to work with this is to dab on your Yubo paper to get a colorful design. For this card I'm going to do some swiping up and down. You see that this way I blend the colors and I get a totally different look on my background. Now I'm going to add even more blue just to darken up my background a little bit, but you see that I ended up having a solid background with stripes, while the first one looks more watercolored. Now let's make a third background. This time I'm using the orange and the yellow alcohol inks. I'm adding enough on my Yubo paper, and I'm going to blow with my straw. I do have some blending solution on my Yubo paper already, and that is why the ink blends nicely and moves so easily. And this time I don't want to cover up completely the whole Yubo paper. I want to embrace that white space at the corner. And you see I'm using with a brush the excess ink that I have on my glass mat to add some splatters. And now one fun technique is to add foil on top of your alcohol ink before it is completely dry. So where that ink is more concentrated, it dries slower and it can pick up some of the foil. So if you find that it doesn't pick up, then let it dry a little bit more, and now it works fine. It is quite difficult for you to see all the shine and where that foil sticks, but trust me, it's there, and it gives a really pretty look on my background. And here is a close-up look on the finished background, trying to catch the light for you, and hopefully you can see where all that foil has stuck on my background. And now let's make a super crazy one. Again, I'm working on Yupo paper. I'm going to apply all three of the colors that are included in the kit. So the orange, the yellow, and I'm also going to add a little bit of blue, which is going to turn looking more green since it's going to blend a little bit with the colors underneath. Now this is not going to be used as a background. I'm just going to let it dry there and I will use it as a palette. You will see the technique later on. So now let's turn all those backgrounds into cards. I'm using my alcohol lift ink and I'm going to apply lots of ink on my beautiful flower arrangement stamp. I am going to make sure that all the ink has transferred. And probably you can see the impression there. Now I'm going to use a clean towel and I'm going to dab all over the stamped area. Make sure that you use clean areas of this paper towel. And then at the end, I'm going to go all over the stamped image and rub it with my paper towel. This is going to help that image to reveal and it's going to give this beautiful ghost look on my beautiful background. I just love this card, one of my favorites from today's cards. And here is a close-up look on this background. Now with such a beautiful background, you don't really need to do a lot for your card. All I did was to chop off the top from this, making sure that I keep the design. And then I used some thin strips of black cardstock on top and at the bottom to mat this panel. And I stuck that on top of my card base. Now for the sentiment, I went with the word smile from the same stamp set that I white embossed. And I also added a few blue gems at the center of my flowers. And that completes the first card for today. Now let's work on this orange background. I want to have a card that is looking quite archy, so I'm going to stamp with black ink. And the good thing about using your stamping platform is that you can go ahead and do it one more time until you're happy with the impression. This is a big stamp, so you need to stamp it a couple of times. I also use some of the individual leaves and stamps that are in the stamp set to fill in the gap that I have in that corner. And then I used my Prismacolor pencil in orange to add some shadows around my leaves and my flowers. You don't really need to do that. The background looks gorgeous as it is. I just wanted to take a step further. And I'm not being very particular here. I'm just adding a little bit of shadows in different parts of the flowers and the leaves. Now, of course, for the sentiment of this card, you can go with any of the sentiments included in the stamp set. I cheated a little bit for this card because I wanted to use this friend die card that I had in my stash and I hadn't used it yet. I'm also adding some gems here and my card is finished. Now for this background, again, I'm using the same technique with the lift ink, which I have placed at the top corner, as you can see here. Again, I'm going to use my paper towel and dab, dab, dab in the beginning, and then I'm going to rub, always making sure that I am using a clean part of my paper towel. And you can see the beautiful reveal. Now I want to turn this into looking more whimsical, so I wanted to add little dots. I'm using this pointy tool there and I'm just adding a little bit of that lift ink. I can rub it with my paper towel and you will see in the close-up photos later on that I ended up having little dots that matched perfectly with my design. So for this card, I went with a sentiment from the stamp set that says sending hugs, and I did add some foam tape at the back of my panel, which I'm going to stick on top of my card base. To finish off my card, I did add some gems again, just because I'm obsessed with them, and my card is finished. Now let's do a really fun technique. This time I'm using my crazy background that I have created earlier, but this time I'm using it as a palette. So all I do is to ink up my stamp with lift ink, and then I pick up color from the background and stamp on paper. This is not Yupo paper, this is normal white paper. So I'm actually lifting color from the background and stamping on my paper. So every time I'm stamping a leaf like here, I pick up color from the areas that are more green and blue. While when I am stamping flowers, I pick up color from the orange and yellow areas. Now, one thing you need to remember is after every stamping, like I'm doing here, I need to make sure that my stamp is completely clear before I go ahead and ink up my stamp again with lift ink. And I'm using actually Stazon ink cleaner here, which works perfectly. And I repeated the same process again and again using my palette. So I ended up having a beautiful pattern paper that I have created by myself. And I love that variation that I get on the flowers and the stamped leaves. And again, for this card, I added the word friend as my sentiment. But of course, you can stamp and cut out any of the sentiments that are included in the stamp set. And I'm also adding some dots in the white areas that I have in between the stamped images with my Nouveau Drops. Now, one thing that you can do with such a big stamp is to use embossing powder. This way you can end up creating a super quick and easy card without having to color anything. So here you can see I'm working on my blue panel. I'm going to stamp my stamp with Versamark ink, making sure that I have transferred my ink there. And then I can apply my white embossing powder and heat set it. Now I'm going to use my white Prismacolor pencil that writes beautifully on top of colored cardstock, and I'm going to add some details on the center of the flowers, around my leaves. These are going to add just some finishing touches. I'm not going crazy with where I'm adding highlighting or shadowing or whatever. I just want to add some detail which is going to highlight more the flowers from the background. And I have also stamped and embossed the sentiment from the same stamp set, as you can see here, that says "Happiest of birthdays to you." I used foam tape at the back, and I'm placing that on top of a white card base. And I'm also going to finish off my card by adding some white Nouveau Drops at the center of my flowers, as well as around the area to give it a more whimsical look. Of course, another way to work with this beautiful jumbo stamp is to use your alcohol markers. I'm using here my Nouveau alcohol markers to color my leaves and my flowers and everything. And I have stamped my image a little bit offset by changing the place where you have stamped your image. You can create totally different look. So I will end up having lots of cards using the same stamp at the end, but you will see that they will all look completely different. For the sentiment, I stamped hello, which comes from the same stamp set with black ink, and I'm going to use some foam tape and stick this panel on top of my blue card base. I finished off my card by using some white Nouveau Drops. And now let's make one more card, but this time with a completely different look. So I'm working on watercolor paper, and I have sprayed all over the surface with water. And I'm going to apply some color with my brush, and I'm using my Altenew watercolor palette. I'm applying my color, making sure that I don't over-concentrate the color in areas. I am letting the color move on its own since I'm working on a wet paper, and I'm not trying to cover up completely the images. I like to have a white space in my images, which is going to add more into the loose watercolor look that I am going for. And I did follow the same technique for all the flowers, so I'm using yellow here to color my flower. I did use pink for the roses, and if you find that your watercolor paper is drying, then don't be afraid to add even more color with your spray bottle. I'm using my yellow watercolor to add some splatters, and then I did stick this panel on top of my yellow card base. And I stamped the word hello on a black strip of paper and white embossed it. Now, to finish off my card, I did add some nouveau drops, just because I had to add nouveau drops on every card. And here are some close-up photos. And now let's play with the three card bases that are in the kit and with the foil. So for the first one, I'm going to completely cover it up with this gorgeous foil. And this is going to turn all the black areas into foiled areas. So I'm placing them in a folded piece of printer paper and I'm going to run it through my laminator. And as this is done, I'm going to cut out smaller pieces for the next card. So I want all these three leaves to be foiled as well. I want to have two of them in gold and one of them in red. Now the first panel is ready, so let's do the big reveal. It's really shiny and really gorgeous. I will try to catch the light for you. And you can do the same process for all three of these panels and create instant cards, really quick and easy and really gorgeous. But I am going to show you a couple of more ideas on how you can take these cards a step further and create a different look than the expected one. So I ran all three panels through the laminator with a foil and now I'm going to turn them into cards. For the first one, I'm using the expected method, so I'm just going to stick this white panel on top of my orange card base, and I'm also going to add some gems at the center of my flowers, and my card is super quick and ready to go. Now with this panel, I'm going to be more creative, so instead of leaving it as it is, I'm going to show you how you can take it a step further. I'm using my scissors and I'm going to fuzzy cut all three leaves. Of course, I'm leaving a white area all around, which is doing my fuzzy cutting a little bit easier. Now I'm working on my orange panel and I'm going to stick some double-sided tape, very thin strips of double-sided tape. And I'm using the lines on my glass mat just to make sure that these are completely straight. So I'm going to stick two of those and I put that leaf there just to make sure that I have enough space to stick them on top. So now I can bring in my foils and I am going to peel off one of those strips. I'm going to place on top my foil. And this is going to cover up completely that line. And I am going to do that one more time for the second strip with gold foil this time. So I'm actually using the two different foils that I used for the leaves. Now I have some foam squares at the back of my leaves and I'm going to stick them down, all three in a row. And all three of them are shiny too, but it's so difficult to catch on camera. Now I'm going to use my paper trimmer and chop off the bottom part just below that foiled line. I'm going to place this panel on a white card base and I'm going to stamp my sentiment in the same color as my cardstock that says sending hugs. And now to the last card for today. I have some smudges here, so I couldn't use it as it is, which means that I need to be quite creative for this card as well. I'm going to chop off top, bottom and all the sides. And I have already foiled this one by using my laminator and the gold foil from the kit. And now I'm going to use my scissors and I'm going to follow the design, cutting off only the top part of my panel. So I'm going to leave a white border around the flowers. This way I'm going to get rid of that smudge that I ended up having at the top, but at the same time I'm going to be more creative than just sticking this panel on top of a card base. And here is the panel that I ended up having. And I have covered this white piece of paper with double-sided tape, so it is sticky all over the place. And now I can apply my foil on top, which is going to cover it up completely. I'm going to remove my foil, and if I end up having some gaps in different areas, I can always go back and fill in the gaps. So I have a gorgeous panel as a backdrop for my flowers. and I'm going to stick them on top by using some foam tape, so I do have some dimension there. And now I can add some white glue on this panel and stick it on top of my orange card base. And here is the finished card, super shiny and really pretty, and some close-up photos, which is the last card for today. So let's go ahead and take a quick look on all the 10 cards that I made for today using lots and lots of techniques, from alcohol inks on Yupo paper, to lift inking, to coloring with alcohol markers and watercolors, to embossing and even to foiling. Lots and lots of techniques in this video. So here are some close-up photos on all the 10 cards that I made for today. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below and let me know which one of the 10 cards was your favorite. And also visit my blog for a chance to win this card kit. And as always, you will find a full list of all the supplies down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.